everybody. Did you realize God has prepared specific works in advance for you to do, according to Ephesians 2:10? It says, "For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do." It may be hugging your child and kissing their boo-boo and cleaning their scrape. It may be sharing Christ with a neighbor. It may be serving your husband, or it may be in a more organized ministry such as PWOC. Each year at this time of year, we begin the process of interviewing and choosing the executive board for next year. This includes the president, spiritual life vice president, programs vice president, financial liaison, and administrative coordinator. These positions are chosen through an application and interview process. Then the new president will choose the rest of the extended board for such positions as childcare coordinator, worship leader, publicity, prayer, community reach, hospitality, participation, and more. Today, I'd like to talk about preparing our hearts to serve in whatever capacity God may call you. Some of you may serve on the executive board, and if so, you're going to need to fill out that application and send it in so that we know that God's working in your heart. Others may serve on the extended board. Others may serve on a committee under one of the board members, and others may serve primarily in your family right now. Wherever God calls us, that calling is noble and beautiful when we respond his way. I'd like to talk about some of the areas that can be kind of tricks and traps for us, and some of the things that hopefully will encourage you as you consider how to serve this year. Philippians 2, 20 and 21 says, Paul said about Timothy, "I have no one else like him who will show genuine concern for your welfare. For everyone looks out for his own interests, not those of Jesus Christ." One thing we have to watch out for is not applying to the board for the wrong reason. Some people feel a need for significance and struggle with feelings of self-worth. Having an official position can temporarily bolster your feeling of self-esteem. People notice you and perhaps admire you and look up to you, but this is the wrong reason to apply to the board. If you struggle with low self-esteem, then that need will overshadow your ability to genuinely serve others selflessly. Whenever someone brings a criticism or a suggestion for improvement, you may take it personally and feel attacked. When someone else does great, you may feel a little bit jealous. When someone doesn't show enough appreciation or approval, you may lash out and complain that they don't appreciate you. Our value comes from God, not from our position or our works on the board. If you recognize yourself in any of this, you can bring your heart to God for healing. Seek out ladies who can work with you to see yourself as God truly sees you. You have value and worth without a position. Let him heal this area so that later you will be free to serve others, perhaps even on a board. The application process itself is a growing process. Perhaps you'll apply this year and not get chosen. Sometimes people get their feelings hurt about that. But actually, the application process is a growing process. You will see areas to target for future growth, and we'll encourage you in those strengths that you already exhibit and in areas that you can improve on. It's often a good growth process to be involved as a team member under a board member before actually taking on a board position also. If that is our recommendation, receive it graciously and commit to growing and learning all you can until God calls you to something else. Second, know that you are not alone. Hebrews 13:5 says, "I will never leave you nor forsake you," says God. God will not send you out. He will go alongside you. Isn't that comforting and encouraging, especially during COVID? Do not expect to accomplish ministry in your own strength. Your top goal will be to seek God daily so his strength, wisdom, and guidance can flow out of you. Next, depend on the right power source. Acts 1:8 says, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you." John 15:4 says, "Remain in me," Jesus said, "as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit of itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me." We can all accomplish a certain amount in our own strength, but lasting spiritual results are only accomplished when God is at work in us and through us. God knows what he wants to do next year. It is our job to seek him and get in line with his plan. God will do his will through people who are seeking him and submitted to him. Daily time with God will be the source of our spiritual strength to accomplish his will next year. Next, I'd like to discuss when you fall short. 2 Corinthians 12:9 says, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness." James 5:16 says, "Therefore confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective." 1 John 1:8-9 says, "If we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness." And finally, Romans 8:1 says, "There is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus." Sooner or later, we all fall short of our best intentions and sincere desire to follow God perfectly. When that happens, God has a path back for us. First, we need to remember that God is for us and not against us. He does not condemn us, but gives us a way to escape our sinful failings. That way includes confessing our sin, first of all, to God. Sometimes it involves confessing our sin to others so they can pray with us for overcoming healing and power. If we've sinned against someone else, it also involves confessing to that person to start the healing process between us. Sometimes we fall short, not in sin, but simply human weakness. We run out of steam and passion. We can bring this to God also and allow him to renew our strength as we wait on him. Next, as we prepare our hearts to serve, we need to develop a teachable and correctable attitude. Psalm 32:9 says, "Do not be like the horse or the mule, which have no understanding, but must be controlled by bit and bridle, or they will not come to you." We have to acknowledge our weak points and be teachable. Let God grow us out of unhealthy patterns of thinking and behavior. The pressures of the position will bring out what's really in us, including our weaknesses. Be proactive to seek resources to grow in areas that you know are hard for you. Seek out mature women to act as mentors and be open to their example and words. We all have lots of room to grow in maturity, and PWC is a great place to practice that. Next, we want to surrender our will to God's will. Galatians 2:20 says, "I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me." We want people to see Christ, not us. He said if he is lifted up, he will draw all people to himself. Anything in us which is not surrendered to God will block God's glory. Instead of others seeing Jesus, they will see the ugly parts of us. As we daily surrender ourselves new to God, he will live his life through us in a beautiful way. Next, we want to seek unity. Ephesians 4:2-3 says, "I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you have received. Be completely humble and gentle, and be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace." And John 13:34-35 says, "A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another." Sometimes you may have a great idea or a passion for something you'd like to see happen in a board position, but somehow it doesn't work with the rest of the board or other priorities for the year. Pray and discuss with everyone, but be willing to set aside your own desires in order to build unity as a body. Don't tear down other board members through backbiting or gossip. People are drawn to God's love. When we let our own agenda and preferences get in the way of unity and love, God's love does not shine brightly. If we value each other and God above our preferences, God will fill next year with an outpouring of his joy and grace and love. So now it's up to you. Pray, and then get up your courage and pick up an application. God bless you.